Welcome to another video here on the Elk 101 YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk about a topic that can be considered a bit controversial, and that's the frontal shot on elk, or any species for that matter. We're going to focus on elk today. So the frontal shot, it's a shot that, you know, all of the misconceptions about it being the size of a baseball, the opening on the front, or it only works if you hit it perfect. I want to talk about some of those factors today, some of the things that we can do to ensure that we're getting a good shot, and then maybe just some simple education on the anatomy of an elk to help us make that decision whether it's for us or not. So before I get into it, if you haven't subscribed to the Elk 101 YouTube channel yet, be sure and click the subscribe button down below and hit the notification bell so that you're getting notified every time we release a new video. A few years ago, I had an opportunity to hunt with Cody and Trent from Born and Raised Outdoors during their filming of Land of the Free, and Trent, on the last day of our hunt, shot a bull frontal. And while we were getting ready to process the elk out in the field, I took just a few minutes and talked about the frontal shot with an actual elk laying there on the ground, and I'll show some of that here in a bit. For demonstration purposes, I'm using a target, which I understand is not the perfect example, but I'm having troubles getting an elk to stand here and let me show this. So we're gonna use a target today. But a frontal shot, the concept of a frontal shot, an elk's coming into you frontal, and we're talking primarily for archery. With rifle, it's not that big of a deal because if you hit anywhere on the front there, you're gonna drop that elk pretty much. So we're talking primarily for archery, and the concept of it is an elk's coming into a shooter straight on. If you're a solo hunter and you're calling, a lot of times that elk's gonna be coming straight to you, and the only shot you're gonna have is a frontal shot. Now the target on a frontal shot is definitely smaller than on a broadside shot, but it's not completely impossible or something that you should just completely write off. With a little bit of education here, hopefully it might become an option for you. For me, it has to be relatively close, and I have to know with full confidence that my arrow is gonna get where it needs to be. And I wanna talk about that. So on the elk, you've got all your vitals back here in the body cavity behind the shoulder. So on a broadside shot, it's relatively easy to know where the lungs are, where the heart is, where the liver is. From a frontal shot, there's maybe some unknown. So it's important to visualize internally where those vitals are in the elk. And when you're shooting frontal, you want to visualize where your arrow is going to end up. Now, the beauty of a frontal shot is you have every single vital that's inside this elk's body is exposed to you from the front. You've got the jugular vein that runs down the neck, branches out all over inside of the neck cavity there. You've got the carotid artery on the other side, one of them supplying blood to the brain from the heart, the other one taking the blood from the brain and going back to the heart, all of the capillaries and arteries and everything coming off of those. So you've got just a complete network and maze of blood, arteries, veins, and vessels in this area in the neck on a frontal shot. That's going to be devastating. If you're able to cut the jugular or the carotid artery, that elk is not going anywhere. You don't want to just rely on that though, because that can be a fairly small target. But inside, once you get inside that body cavity, you've got lungs, you've got heart, you've got all of the veins and arteries and everything running to and from the heart right there. It's a very devastating vital shot. The key to it is finding the thoracic opening. And that's the opening on the front of the rib cage where all of the ribs come together that provides basically access into that vital cavity. Now, if you look on a real elk, you'll notice there's a lump right here, and it's about the position where the coloring goes from light brown to dark brown, the dark brown of the mane. You'll notice that big lump right there. And that lump on an elk is the sternum. That's the point where all of those ribs come together and attach on the front of the elk there. You don't want to aim for that lump. If you hit right there on that lump too low, you're not going to penetrate that mass of ribs right there. We can break a rib going through on a broadside shot. We can break a rib up here a little higher, but right there on the sternum, you're asking for trouble if you hit too low. The other thing to keep in mind is you've got these shoulders. You've got the leg bone that comes back and then it actually angles right up. There's a lump right here on the elk, and then the shoulder blade goes back from there. You wanna avoid that lump as well. If your arrow hits right there on the shoulder bone, you're not gonna penetrate. The only other thing you want to be concerned of is the angle of the elk. If the elk's coming in quartering to you and you try to shoot, again, visualize where those vitals are. If the vitals are back behind the shoulder here and you're shooting at a sharp angle and the arrow goes just in front of that shoulder bone, it's not going to actually penetrate into the vital cavity there. What you want to do is make sure you've got enough of an angle to miss the shoulder bone and still get that arrow so it's at least getting back behind the offside shoulder. That's going to produce at least a one lung hit in addition to all of the vitals, the veins, everything up in the neck here, and that's going to kill that elk. There's three things when people talk about frontal shots that they don't like. Either they've had a bad experience with it, they know somebody who has, or they don't know the anatomy of the elk well enough to be confident in taking that shot. When it comes to those who have had bad experiences with it, there's really three things. I've mentioned a couple of them. Number one, they shoot just a little bit too low and they hit that sternum and they don't get good penetration. I've had several hunters say, my arrow buried clear to the fletching and it didn't kill the elk. The frontal shot's a bad shot. It's not that the frontal shot's a bad shot, it's just the placement of their specific shot wasn't ideal. What typically happens in that case is we're off just a little bit to the side or just a little bit of an angle, and that arrow actually can travel into the neck at a perfect height, go right behind that shoulder bone right there. It actually goes behind it so it doesn't hit it and stop, but it slides between the rib cage and that shoulder bone and never actually penetrates the body cavity. So it'll bury full length just like that and lay right there with the shoulder bone over the top of it, but never inside the rib cage. And it might come out, it might completely pass through and go clear through that elk and not be more than just a flesh wound for the elk. The other thing is if they hit that shoulder bone on either side, either a bad angle this way or straight on and hit it and don't penetrate. Those three things will make a frontal shot bad. But if you look at a broadside shot, you've still got shoulder, you've got low brisket, you've got guts behind it. There are things that can go bad on a broadside shot as well. With a frontal shot, the target's smaller, the margin of error is smaller, so you aren't gonna wanna take a frontal shot at 50 yards. But inside 20 or 25 yards, the actual thoracic opening on that elk is about 7 inches wide by about 9 or 10 inches tall. So you've got a really good target there on the front that at 20 yards, I would hope that anybody can hit a 7x10 target consistently. Now, if the elk's looking at you and he's ready to whirl, that might not be the best shot. But if that bull's coming in 20 yards looking straight through you and you know where to put that arrow, it's a great devastating shot. I have not seen an elk where the arrow buries into the body cavity going through the frontal thoracic opening that makes it more than 80 yards. Once in a while we'll get one at a bad angle or something will happen and it'll take a little bit longer. But if you can make that shot into the thoracic opening, that 7x10 inch opening on the front, that elk's not going anywhere. So a couple things to keep in mind, location of that opening. When we're shooting at an elk from broadside, we wanna be center of the body right behind the shoulder. So that arrow is gonna be going in right like that. That's gonna be center of the lungs, top of the heart. That's gonna be a great broadside shot. When we go frontal, we just simply want to bring that elevation around to the front. And that's putting it right there. Now, when you look at that entry point, clear up here, you're thinking that's shooting that elk in the neck. And realistically, that is what you're doing. If you're down here on the brisket, you're too low. So what I want to do is take a look at the video we filmed in Wyoming a couple years ago and show on an actual elk so you can see the muscle and the shoulder bone. You can see the sternum and get an idea for where you want to place that arrow. But it's usually about 8 or 9 inches above the sternum, right about there. That arrow is going to penetrate, and you'll notice you've got to get about probably 20 inches of penetration there to be able to get the broadhead back into the lungs, solidly into the lungs. Once you get that 20 inches of penetration, you've went through jugular, you've went through carotid artery, you went through the top of the heart, you're in the lungs. Most of the time, if you hit that thoracic opening at 20 yards with any kind of a decent shooting bow as far as speed and a good weight arrow, a lot of times that arrow is going to end up back here in a back hip. And it's going to be in there, it's going to devastate the internals of that elk, and he's not going to make it very far at all. So there's a couple things. First off, you've got the sternum right here, which is where it goes from dark to light. you don't want to shoot there. That sternum's where all the ribs come together and you've got a solid mass of rib right there. You want to be above that. And the thing to remember is on a broadside shot, you want to be center of the body. So when you bring that around to frontal, you want to be same area. So right up here, about 9 inches above the sternum, above that lump you see there, you want to be about 9 inches above that. And you want to hit it straight on so that arrow comes into the body cavity. If you shoot at an angle, you can glance over inside the shoulder blade and that arrow can actually come out behind the shoulder blade and not even get in the cavity. The other thing you want to miss is this great big lump right here. That's his shoulder bone. That bone right there, you'll get no penetration if you hit it or if you angle into it. So front on, 9 inches above the sternum, right there. It's actually, it looks like it's in the throat, but that's going to put the arrow right here, center of lungs. And on Trent, perfect height. That hole right there is money. The arrow actually came in at a little angle, the bull whirled just a little bit, and so it didn't get full penetration into the body cavity, but it got plenty to get inside that diaphragm and do all the damage it needed to do. So that thoracic opening, front of the elk, is about 7 inches by 9 inches. And if you can hit that hole, you've got a free pass into every vital inside that elk's body. So hopefully that explanation, both here on the target and on the actual elk, helps you understand where to place a frontal shot, the actual opening that you're shooting for, where it's located, and how to pick that spot. There's a full module in the University of Elk Hunting online course about anatomy of an elk, blood trails, shot placement, shot angles, everything. If you want to learn more, be sure and visit elk101.com and sign up for the University of Elk Hunting online course and use the promo code YouTube to save $10. In that, you're going to find all sorts of diagrams, skeletal diagrams, circulatory diagrams, everything for a broadside shot, for a frontal shot. We're going to talk about different blood trails that you're going to produce from different shot locations to be able to help you in the field be more successful and recover more elk. So thanks so much for joining us in today's video. For more information, be sure and check out elk101.com and leave us a comment down below. Tell me your experiences or your thoughts on the frontal shot. What's kept you from making it? What bad experiences have you seen? Or are you a firm believer in the devastation of the frontal shot? The success rate for do-it-yourself public land elk hunters hovers around 10%. The reality of that statement is that 9 out of 10 elk hunters each fall fail to fill their tag, or the average elk hunter only fills their elk tag once every 10 years. But average no longer applies to you. Crush the averages and sign up for the University of Elk Hunting online course today and become a consistently successful elk hunter.